All right. Everybody ready? Get started. If you would, ask for the mic when you have a question. And Skylar, I'll start off and let you kind of recap what's going on with the team and especially the recent trip to Spain.
Yeah, we just had our first day of boot camp, two more days of that, and I feel like we got a leg up on probably the competition with the Spain trip, and just getting to go out there to a whole different culture and experience that, and do all the sightseeing and learn a little bit about the history, and obviously bonding off the court and getting those 10 extra practices in the summer, and being able to get a couple games in against quality competition is definitely beneficial for us, and hope that springboards us into practice Friday. So.
Question for you.
Yeah, when you're able to travel abroad with all these guys, how much of a chemistry building advantage does that give you guys, especially coming off of the season where you lost a couple of key players?
Oh, it was awesome, and it kind of went like as I figured. With us just having so many talented players that are smart and unselfish, so sometimes it looked like we were getting ready for SEC play with it as far as the chemistry, and then obviously we had points where we kind of looked like we just didn't know what the others had going on. So, it's definitely a good experience to get on the court as soon as possible, even if it's before the games actually count.
How has the chemistry kind of developed between you and Javante now being the kind of the backcourt duo that's going to lead things next year?
It's been great. Both of us with our ability to play off the ball, we can kind of take the pressure off each other as far as, making decisions for the team, whether it's calling a play or, just getting in the paint and making a play for someone else. And we got a little bit of that, experience in a couple of the games last year. Some games when Trey wasn't able to play, and then, sometimes we had lineups where me and him were the guys making up the backcourt. So, we're definitely going to build on that, but I like where we're at right now.
What have you seen from James and Charles in their time here so far?
James has been awesome to start. James, unbelievable worker, unbelievable person. Really, I think he'll be, as solid of a freshman as you can probably expect, especially in a conference like this. Charles has definitely gone at me in practice and made it a point of his to defend me every practice and challenge me with his on the ball defense, and he's made a lot of strides, and both of those guys have made a lot of big strides since they've gotten on campus. I can go down the line if y'all wanted to ask about Trendon and all those guys too.
Oh, yeah.
I got to remind me of the names. We got a couple new faces. Trendon. He's so versatile. He can play pretty much all five spots, which is going to be big for us. And he's going to have a great year for us because he comes in and listens on top of the talent that he has. Parker, a lot of guys are familiar with Parker and what he did to us. And he continues to do that in practice, and he's going to be a big piece of what we're able to do. Caleb Starks. I put Marlon probably is the only athlete that's better than him on this team, and just another guy who comes to work every day and approaches things the right way. So it was a seamless transition for him from LSU E to here. What other names we got?
Deshaun,
yeah. New guy. He was able to come to Spain with us, and great guy. He's been dealing with a couple of injuries that's kept him out of practice, but when he is out there, he plays hard. He listens. I feel like he's going to be an elite, definitely an elite rebounder for us. Just comes in to play his role, and I'm excited about what he's been able to do in the short time that he's been here.
Yeah, of returning players, who do you see as taking a pretty big leap of improvement with what you see?
If I had to put it on one person, I would say probably Emmett and his leadership and his maturity and how he's grown in that sense. And I think it's just growth in that area has, you know, helped his game all around. And, you know, he's expanding his game a lot. He's shooting the ball a lot better in practice, and we're expecting that to translate to the games. And, but, you know, Javonte's, you know, done a great job with leadership improvement, and, you know, he's always been a really vocal guy, and he's been able to use that more in this role than we're always going to have on our team. Another guy that doesn't get as much recognition probably is Cortese, and I think just the way he's been battling against him and that type of battle that they've been having, Cortese has made a lot of improvements.
Scott.
So, Skyler, you went to a new country.
Yeah.
Did you learn any new language? Did you try any new food? What were the people like?
Yeah, Coach Golden introduced me to a bunch of different things as far as food, but I did okay with the Spanish out there because I took 4 years of it in high school, and helped me out a good bit. But with the food, I definitely want to shout out Coach Golden for introducing me to different stuff like the IA. I don't know if I'm saying it right, stuff like that.
You mentioned Cortese, but also Andre was on the team last year. Just kind of how were those two developed from year one to year two in the program?
Andre's been awesome. He was amazing out there in Spain. I think he had one game where he may have had eight rebounds and six offensive rebounds. That's stuff that we get excited about. He shot the ball really well. He had to shoot the ball probably 60% from three out there. So, you know, we expect him to build on that. That's kind of his niche on this team. And, you know, he's going to have a great year, too.
During the offseason, you went through the pre-draft process, tested the waters. What did you learn in that experience, and how much do you think you grew going through that?
Yeah, I think that was a great experience for me, and with the new rules that were put in place, I felt like it kind of would have been stupid not to at least go through it and, you know, get that hands-on experience and hear from the people that make those decisions as far as your future if you want to go that route. So to work out for five different teams and get good enough feedback to where I had to make a tough decision, it only gives me confidence for this year and how I can improve on my game and, you know, show that to NBA scouts.
Can you just talk about, I guess, you know, in the weeks after the season, the uncertainty with Will, with guys declaring to take a look, it was like, had all this stuff going on. What was it like to finally know that Will was coming back, all the guys were coming back, just like kind of got the band back together? What was it like to that feeling like,
yeah,
everything's back to normal?
Yeah, it was good. You know, just having that stability makes it easier to move forward with, you know, the plan that he has in place for us, the plan that he has in place for just the LSU basketball program. So knowing that stability is there helps you let go of any stresses, and you can just get back to work and, you know, put a great product on the court.
Anything else, guys?
When you look back in the last year, you kind of wonder how y'all actually all did that down the stretch. You won a championship and advanced to the Sweet 16. You look back like, God, we can handle all that adversity and still got there. Your thoughts.
Yeah.
Give me your thoughts, like, you looking back on it, like, man, we handled all that, and we got there. I mean, we can handle anything.
Yeah, we definitely dealt with a lot before the season even started. Around this time, it makes a year Saturday since what happened with Wade. So, you know, I'm definitely looking forward to this Saturday and getting to go to the graveside, and we're going to do something for him. It's crazy to think that it's been a year since then, and you know, all the things that have happened that year, but I think it's helped each of us grow as individuals outside of basketball, and you know, helped us develop a confidence that I feel like you can only develop through our type of experience, not just because it wasn't just something normal. I'd say we came out very successful, and I'll get a little jewelry to show that we did the right thing, and good things came from all that we went through.
Yeah.
So
Scott, if I could ask you, you know, being on campus with the other student athletes, what's your opinion of Joe Burrow, the new offense, all the points? What's that like
man,
to
watch? It's his world. We're just living in it, man. He's been awesome. I haven't got to meet him personally, but, just by watching his interviews and stuff like that and following him, he seems like he approaches everything the right way, like a champion's supposed to. And, we're hoping